What's going on, guys? It is Bernard from the BTNHD, and today is all about Smart Deploy and installing it and configuring it. So if you dealt with MDT and SCCM, you know that MDT and SCCM, you have to do a lot to get those two services up and running to work successfully within your environment. Now, Smart Deploy is basically a dumbed down version of MDT and SCCM combined. So the way it works would be Smart Deploy, MDT, and then SCCM. And then SCCM with MDT. I think that's the way that the hierarchy will work out for me. Smart Deploy is one of those things that you would implement inside a client site if they do not have a in-house technician to manage a deployment server. This is what you will use. Okay, so let's get into it. All right, so today is all about installing and configuring Smart Deploy within Windows Server 2019. I'm going to build this nice little mini series with you guys. So this is the first part. All right, so first things first, I'm going to right click on my start menu, going to go to run, type in WinVER, hit OK. And my primary environment right now is Windows Server 2019. Version 1809, build 17763. I'm going to open up my favorite web browser, which is Google Chrome, and I'm going to type in Windows ADK, and I'm going to click on the link to download and install the Windows ADK. Make sure that you install those three particular files, your Windows ADK, as well as your Windows PE, and also your Windows System Image Manager update. When you're installing Smart Deploy into your workstation, right? I'm doing it within a server environment, but you can actually install it within a Windows 10 environment. It actually installs Windows ADK for you automatically, so you don't have to drive yourself crazy doing this. I like doing it this way because I'm so used to my old habits dealing with MDT and SCCM. You have to install Windows ADK before you install MDT. So that's the reason why I'm doing it. But you don't really need to do this because Smart Deploy will install it for you. I'm gonna click on Start, type in Control Panel. Within Control Panels, I'm going to go in Programs and Features, and I already have my Windows ADK already up and running. That's the reason why I'm not showing you guys how to click next, 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 and install. Now to get started, how to install and configure Smart Deploy. Really easy, you're gonna open up your favorite browser, type in smartdeploy.com/sign-in, sign in with your business email and a password. Click that big button that says download now, and it's going to start processing and downloading. Now, the file is around 1.3 gigs, which is a pretty big exe file. Once it's done, I'm going to hit that little arrow, show in folder, and there goes the SDE setup file. So I'm going to right click on it and run it as an administrator. Because I'm using Windows Server 2019, it's going to say, Windows protected your PC. So I'm going to click on more info, and it gives me a breakdown, you know, particular app that is trying to run behind the scenes and the publisher. I trust it, so I'm going to hit run anyway. A couple of things that this guy needs to work properly within your environment. Install SQL Server Express as well as SQL Server Compact 4.0 Service Pack 1 onto your machine. So when you click on install, it's going to start installing the local DB for you. Again, it is going to be SQL Server 2014 Express. We're going to click next here, accept the license and terms, next again, install. It's going to start doing its thing. Once it's done, hit finish. Once you're done with that, it's going to start installing the SQL Server compact files. Just let it happen. It's going to do its thing. It's going to start processing the compact files. Once it's done, it's going to start preparing to install the Smart Deploy for you. You're going to get a Windows installer. You're gonna get this, you're gonna click next, accept the license and terms, click next again, install. It's gonna start installing, it's gonna start the services for you, and voila, you're done. Automatically, you're gonna have the check mark of launch Smart Deploy. All you gotta do is just hit finish, and it's gonna launch up. Now, your username and password is not a Active Directory username and password. It is the email and password that you use to log into smartdeploy.com. Okay, because that email address, that business email address, is locked down to the license that you have. So into that information, it's going to launch up and log you into the console. When you're logged into the console, you're going to get this nice little warning about that Windows Defender might affect the performance of capturing your image. You want to hit yes on this part because you want it to create a rule within Windows Defender so it won't affect the performance. So say do not show this again and hit yes, and then you're good to go. Now, this is the interface, super self-explanatory. Again, this is just showing you guys how to install and configure it. Later on, we're gonna break this down even further because it was super simple to get everything running. One of the cool things about the console is if you check advanced mode, gives you a bird's eye view. And one of the things that caught my eye is upload cloud package. Did my research with SmartDeploy is that you're able to deploy your image to outside workstations off your network. That is awesome. This definitely works out for consultants. You have a consultant with a laptop that has an old image and you want to deploy your new image to that consultant laptop. That's not part of your network. You're actually able to push it out using the cloud services within SmartDeploy. And that's it, guys. Hopefully, you guys enjoyed this video. Don't forget about hitting that like button. Also, punch, elbow, smash that subscribe button to get the latest and greatest from this guy. Also, share out the video. And I catch you guys on the next part dealing with SmartDeploy. Peace out.